Well, it's about time I got this video posted. I've been busy with a couple of computer projects that came up and some of the things. So I'm glad to get this out because I'm sure you've been wondering what happened after I ended up back in La Crosse. So this will pick up the day I got back there and started this whole process over again. And I enjoyed some rail fanning. Man, it was busy there while I was waiting on my train to come through. Before I start though, just a quick reminder, there is a drawing in effect right now for a UV5R. Make sure and click the link in the description if you haven't so that you can get entered for that drawing. And also I've got to give a shout out to Aaron Lasley, a friend of the channel from Southeast Nebraska, has sent me at his cost a couple of gifts to give away on the channel. So I will announce those after the winner of the drawing is announced, but we'll have, or the radio drawing that is, but we'll have a couple more drawings coming up courtesy of Aaron Lasley. So thanks, Aaron, and thanks everybody for all of your support, all the channel members, greatly appreciated, and subscribers, etc. So don't forget to subscribe if you haven't, and click that bell so you get notified of drawings and whatnot. Anyway. Here we go, headed back west, this time hopefully making it further than St. Paul. So this other train's been sitting there quite a while, waiting to make their crew change. And I think longer than an hour, maybe pushing 2 hours. But man, it's a gorgeous evening, even if there is a lot of smoke in the air. It's Groundhog Day, like the movie. We're doing this thing over. I think the train I rode last night has already come through, so my chances of getting on the wrong train have been diminished by a third. I think they're just starting to move. Glad, I was hoping they'd be out of the way just in case. I didn't want to have to. Something heavier than normal grain. That's why they only have two hoppers instead of three. Well, here we are. It's the window is open for the first of the intermodals, either one of which I want. The Z train to Seattle, South Seattle, or to Portland, either one of them. Not going to ride that far without stopping. But anyway, it is just an incredibly gorgeous evening. Unbelievable. And while I did get fairly well eaten up last night when I camped out, I have not noticed a mosquito one here this evening, which is rare for right here, for sure. That'll probably change as it gets a little darker.
Well, here comes something rolling in. Another train idling up. It's kind of coasting to a stop. Probably waiting on clearance to go across the diamond. Expecting my train, but this looks like a junk train from what I can see of it. So that's not my ride. Thank you. yellow, solid yellow to red on that track. So that would tell me we're catching up. Thank you.
Midway yard. We didn't pull into it this time. But I don't know what we're doing. We've just been sitting here for about 5 minutes. I think they split our trains and had us pull ahead past a switch and then back up and connect to another string. And I'm guessing we'll pull forward again and connect back up to the rest of our train. And then we'll probably be good to go out of here. At least I'm hoping that's the case. Because right now, I'm a ways away from the yard itself.
Thank you.
Fargo, the population density drops pretty drastically. Gotta watch out more for construction and whatnot along the railroad than actual people watching for trains. Of course, that could be famous last words. My blow-up pad, my super lightweight sleeping bag. Man, I slept pretty well, as train sleep goes. Oh, we're coming to a siding. I better duck in case there's something on this other side.
cloud blocking the sun for a moment.
I decided to switch sides, but it's going to be a tight fit over here. Oh, sounds like they're going to have to change out a unit. And I didn't want to sit in the sun that whole time.
Thank you.
Amtrak is right behind us. So we're gonna get put in the hole, I would think, pretty soon to let them get around. We just crossed over into Montana.
So basically, Amtrak passed us last night by, I think we were pretty close to St. Cloud. And then they go up to Grand Forks and come across through Minot. And basically, we beat them here. Cool area with these clay outcroppings. Lots of weathered volcanic ash in North Dakota, Montana. Well, here comes Amtrak. Should blow by fast enough that all I gotta do is get down, I think. We beat it to here, from St. Paul to here. Thank you.
Minot.